Oh my, I think I got him. I got him. My bill wasn't even closed, I still got him. It is tiny, of course. Come on, fight. I took the energy right out of him. Again, nerve baby, not my favorite. Grab him like they're supposed to. I pooped on me. I'm just gonna drop him in. I don't even care. Third fish, that's all you gotta know. Alrighty, so today we are at one of my lakes that I grew up fishing my whole life. It's full of carp, full of catfish. And today I'm gonna teach y'all how to catch a bullhead. As you can see, we got our little spin cast combo and then my favorite rod combo, the ultralight. As you see, it's early spring, we got some shoots along the edges there, which is a great sign that spring is here, although it is a balmy 48 degrees. Let's go over the gear we're using here to catch these bullheads. We got a slide sinker on the ultralight, and on this rod, a spin cast rod, we got it's kind of like a hybrid between a bolt rig and then a crappie rig. It's all combined to one. I'll show you the rig. And I'll link the two videos that I got most of my advice from down below about how to catch bullheads. And yeah, let's go ahead and get started. And let's get to catching some. So why would you bullhead fish when there are blue cats, channel cats, and these flatheads, and so much other bigger species to be caught? Well, for one reason, bullheads are found most across North America, and they're typically very easy to catch, regardless of the time of year. Especially if you're in a dirty little farm pond like this. If you're in a big lake, it's a bit harder, in my opinion, but yeah, they're just really easy to catch, especially during this time of quarantine where you're just trying to get out of the house and catch something. I think you got a bite right here. Yeah, it's a very fun fish to catch when you're in quarantine and you don't want to get skunked. Now, what's nice about the way we're catching these bullheads, we're using worms. That's why I grew up catching them on. This nice about bullheads, they eat pretty much anything. But I'm using worms today just because we are in quarantine. We're trying to store up some food. So, but yeah, they'll eat corn, Slim Jims, hot dogs, livers. You name it, they'll eat it. Pretty much the typical bait used for catfish. Just downsize a little bit. You notice I'm using these long shank hooks, especially on the ultralight. If you have any sort of small hook, it will work for bullhead. The type of bullhead we're fishing for are black bullheads and yellow bullheads. Those are the type of bullheads in this lake. Because a lot of times how these bullheads hit, they'll often not slacken it, and that's how you know you got a bite. And even if they stop biting for, even if they just keep tapping at it, you can count on them to eventually commit, just because bullheads cannot resist a worm most of the time. So that's what we're working with now. Our attempts were consistently in the 50s last week, but since these past couple snaps, I bet it's down in the high 40s. So a bite may be a little bit slow, but in small ponds like this, you can pretty much catch a bullhead year round. You just gotta find the deep holes and use the right tactics. You know, use light line, use worms, corn, stuff that they like, you know. Oh yeah, you can even use cut bait for, they love cut bait in here, especially the big ones. So when I use cut carp in this lake, I often catch bullheads between 1 and 2 pounds, which are massive for the species that are in here. So, well, I don't recommend using for bullheads. As you can see, I got my favorite rod, but I always bring it out here just because the fish out here are generally small, and so to use an ultralight just makes things a lot more fun. But I also got my little spin cast set up, and like I said, all the videos I'm talking to, like I'm getting this information from and passing on to you guys, is linked in the description below, so go check that out. I'm using a spin cast because it's perfect for the situation, which you can see it's got that closed cap, so no dirt. It's very dirty, obviously. Whereas if you use like your nice bass fishing setup on a muddy bank, it's gonna get ruined. It's pretty much gonna get ruined. So the reel's gonna sound grimy. It's gonna be a pain in the butt to clean. So I just don't recommend using your like nicest rods and stuff when fishing for bullheads, unless that's all you got. Basically, you use what you have. But most of the time, you have a cheap setup, and yeah. Yep, that's a bullhead. Gotta wait for that good pull. Got him. Out deep. That's a nice fish. Whatever it is. Oh, don't tell me he came off. No! Holy cow. We can get back out there. What's nice too, that's great now, because now that you know that there's fish in the area, that felt like a really nice bullhead, boys. But anyway, now that you know that there's fish in the area, and you cast back to the exact same spot, that scent is going to be there. If you watch one of the other videos, the guy uses analysis like a dog on a rabbit trail and stuff. Oh, I'm already getting bit. Here we go. Got him. I'm not losing this fish. See what I mean? Cast right back in there. Oh, man. That was immediate. That's what I'm saying. Probably a whole school attracted that scent. This feels nicer than the first one. Oh, that's a big catfish. There we go. On the old Zebco. Tells you you don't need in a lot. Let's take a look at this fish. That is a nice bullhead. Now, obviously, there's a few different ways to hold bullheads. I like to lip lock them like a bass. It doesn't hurt that bad. That's what people tell you this. They're like, oh, it hurts because they got this. They got those rough, sandy patches. Oh, yeah, and they bite, not to mention. But, yeah, as soon as I threw that in, that's insane. And that's the one-pound bullhead I was talking about. But there's another way you can hold him, because they got these spines. That's why people talk about them so much. They got two on their fins and then one on the dorsal fin there. So you can go in and hold them like this as well, if you don't want to get bit like I just did. And, sometimes they don't want to let go. There we go. And, yeah, there we go. That is a above average size catfish, especially for the species. This is a black bullhead, by the way. But yellow bullheads, you know, it's yellow, but they would normally have these yellow barbels. So the black bullhead, it goes by the color of its barbels there. And so that's how you know it's a black bullhead. Really nice first fish there. And that's how you catch a bullhead. Massive one at that. Let's go ahead and get a release on this dude. See you, dude. Woo! He is gone. Nice fish. Nice first fish. Let's go. And also, if you're not familiar with catfish, they have those whiskers or barbels. And they use those to smell and feel stuff and taste stuff. They have taste buds on them, so that's mainly their way of finding food. If you can appeal to those senses, like using a very, like worms in this case, they're very smelly, especially when you hook it multiple times, like I have here. If you hook it multiple times, it releases multiple avenues of scent, and so more scent equals the better chance a catfish in the area is going to come by and hit it. So I did go to a local community lake in the area, and I also caught some fish. I used a slightly different rig, you know, the standard drop shot rig or crappie rig is what we call it. I'm not using it today, but that's another rig you can use. Anything that's going to sit a worm on the bottom. I know people use bobbers for bullheads, but I want to use that in early spring just because they're going to be cruising the bottom most of the time in early spring, and especially in the winter. As once again, I apologize for being not so fluent in English, I guess. I don't know. I can't speak today to save my life.
Oh, there's fish on. Begin. Fish sitting. I can win the beds, bullhead.
Not as big as the first one. Of course, not much is going to top that first one. I'm not going to cap, but that's often an occurrence here. They'll often take a look at that, swallowed that. That's why it's important to use a barbless, long shank hook. Ooh, something got him right there. Look at that. The tail. There we go. Yeah, I bent that hook out, but I'm going to let him keep that worm. Look at that. Perfectly healthy little bullhead. And go back. See you later. Really nice young ultralight. Got him. There we go. Nice fish. Trying to keep that tension. I'm telling you, 2 pound test. I'm a huge advocate for light tackle fishing. And this is why. Look at this. I could horse this fish pretty easily on that yellow rod, but. Woohoo! I didn't even get to see it. I think it's another nice bullhead. I'm sure it is. Feels like it. Not really much of fighters, but I'm telling you, these... Yeah, look at this. get one big enough, a line. Oh yeah, it's a nerve giant. I swear, our average size has been about a pound. We might actually weigh this fish just for kicks and giggles. Hey, you get these big enough ones, they can pull some drag. I might tackle. Let's go ahead and get down here. Oh, he's barely hooked, actually. Hook just popped out. That was all tension. Yeah, another nice fish. Let's get the scale on him. That's about the same size fish, about a foot long. Pretty, it's huge for either species. So we have the world record is like 6 pounds, and here we already caught 3 1-pounders. It's an awesome average size. You often fish for these, and you also think these big ones are channel cats. Well, if you look at the tail, you can see that square tail right there. That's a characteristic of a bullhead and small flatheads. And the way you can tell that is just that bite right there is pretty. Whoops. As you can see right there, it's a little dirty, but the bite is pretty even. Flatheads have more of an underbite or an overbite. I can't remember. I think it's an underbite, but yeah, it's pretty rusty. He is just under a pound. If I had to get my digital scale, it's probably around 0.8 or 0.9. So let's go clean him off and let's go put him back. Well, I tried getting a swimmer relief, but I was cleaning him off, and yeah, he swam away. He was perfectly fine. So anyway, I want to thank y'all so much for watching. Make sure, while we are in a time of, I guess you can call it crisis, it's a break from reality. So while you're in this isolation period, go catch some fish. Go outside, get fishing, and we'll see you next time.
A bad day of fishing beats a good day of anything, yeah.
Well, so this is awkward. I kept fishing after I ended this video. Look what I caught. I don't catch these every day out here. I'm just gonna say that. That's a really odd catch you're gonna get with worms. Huh. Interesting.